Okay guys, so the first thing which we are going to today, guys, so the first we are going to today,
Actually, we are getting an echo of your voice.
okay, wait a second.
Now it should be fine.
Okay, so now what we are going to cover is No, sir, actually the echo is again going.
I can't hear any echo.
Not
I also
echoing, ma'am.
I'm not
Same
echoing.
here.
Not echoing, ma'am.
Same here.
Not
Not an
echoing,
echo.
ma'am.
Okay.
Okay, everyone be on mute. I'll log myself and then let's see.
Okay, so our first topic which we are going to cover today is types of operators. Okay, so now what are operators? Operators is a thing which we will see and we will perform some operations on that. Okay, so now moving to our next slide. We have types of operators which we are going to cover, that is the arithmetic, assignment, comparison, logical, bitwise, identity, and membership. Clear to all?
Yes,
Yes,
ma'am.
ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so first let's see what is an arithmetic operator. So basically, arithmetic operators are the basic operations like plus, minus, multiplication, division, modulus, quotient, and exponent. Okay, so let's do it on Google Colab and see that how do we do that. So I'm opening here Google Colab. You all just open that Google Colab in your laptops. Okay, so it's opening. Let's wait for the network. Guys, have you opened Google Colab?
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, actually, it's asking for a Google account to sign in. Can you please sign in with your account here?
Hello.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Is it fine or
No,
something
it's
else?
fine. It's fine. Thank you. Now, let's take an example for the arithmetic operator. As we have seen, the arithmetic operators are the addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and all these things. So basically, what we are doing is that let's write here. Just a second. A is equal to, let's take A as a value of 10. Next second, we are going to take a variable B and assign it a value as 20. Now, thirdly, what we are going to do is that let's take a variable C and let's assign it, give it as A plus B. And now the final, which we are going to do is that print C. Now, let me explain that what have I done here is that I have taken a variable A and assigned it a value of 10. Now, secondary, what I have done is that I have taken another variable b and assigned it a value of 20. Now, thirdly, what I have done is that I have taken a third variable c, and what I have done a plus b. Now, this plus sign, which here is a arithmetic operator, and a and b here acts as the operands. So this might be clear to you that the plus, I mean the operator, that is the arithmetic operator, and the two other variables a and b, they treat r as the operands. And after that, I have printed the result, print c. So basically in Python, we write print and after that the variable name c to print any output or result. Clear?
Yes.
So have you all written the same code with me or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the so how do we run this cell is that you can either click on this circle, or you can put this cursor here, or you can use shift and enter. If you do shift plus enter, say the circle is running, and you will get an output, and our output is 30. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So you all must have done this plus addition operator with me. Now firstly do this minus operator.
Just a minute, ma'am. We actually have to do
okay
I did.
Okay, we are waiting. Let them do. So the ones who have done, try it for the other arithmetic operators which I have told. Plus, minus, multiplication, division. Do it fast. Done?
Yes, ma'am. Output is not coming, ma'am.
Okay, so the assignment, have you written the thing which I have written?
Yeah, ma'am, got it. I think it takes 5 to 6 seconds.
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, Manas, so for running it, you can either click on the circle which is present here, or you can do shift plus enter. Try run it fast. We need to move further. Okay, so this was the arithmetic operator.
Running, ma'am.
Okay, who is this?
Not running in system.
What are you using, Abhishek?
Collaboratively, ma'am. Wait, Google Collab.
Okay. Dakshaini, please close your mic. Okay, so Abhishek, have you connected it? Like in the upper side, it must be showing an option here to connect this RAM disk. Have you done that?
Yes, ma'am.
Connected that, no? So is it showing some? Is it showing some error or what?
Error showing, ma'am.
Okay, so do one thing. Whatever code you have written, just copy that code and send it in the comment box fast. rest all of you have got the outputs, right?
Yeah, running, ma'am, running. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Now, next we are moving towards the second one. That is assignment operators. So basically, assignment operators are plus equal. Okay, so who was this run?
Ma'am, I only hola.
What's the, you are getting any error?
Yes, ma'am.
What error?
Ma'am, syntax error. Invalid syntax.
Okay. Just a second. Share the code which you have written. Just fastly copy that code and share in the comment box.
Okay.
And the rest who have done this, have you tried for all the six things which I have told in the arithmetic operators?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please.
All the six?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that's nice. Let's wait 1 second. Like your friend is facing any problem, let's solve that and then move on further. Okay, so I have a question for them who have done this, all the six operators. Like, do one thing. You have taken A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20. You have taken three these values, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So do one thing. You have taken a variable C is equal to A plus B.
Ma'am, absent.
Okay, I will check just a second, Supriya. So you have taken a variable C is equal to A plus B. Now what you have to do is that you need to take different variables and perform all the operations in a single code. Like I'm showing you example here that you have taken C is equal to A plus B. Now take like this only D is equal to A minus B. And then after that here, print D. Okay, so do this for all the six types of six operators which we have seen passed, and I want that codes in the comment box.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Which what to do in Colab? I'm at the Colab homepage, Google Colab homepage. Now,
okay, you have opened Google Colab. There must be an option like here. You must be having this screen, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Then click here on file and open this new notebook. Done?
Yes.
The notebook will appear like this. Okay, then here there will be one option to connect. Then connect that and then you will be able to write and run all the codes.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome. Yes, Supriya, you are having A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20, C is equal to A plus B. Listen, Supriya. Have you written this thing? Like here you have written 3 is 3 and then C is equal to A plus B. And after that, where is your 4? Is it missing here only or you have missed that 4 in this code also?
Missing, ma'am.
Do that. Dakshani E D A B C D. Okay, very good. Very good, Dakshani. Very good. Has the code run, Supriya?
No, ma'am.
मैम आई हैव अ डाउट मैम दैट मैम आई यूज द परसेंटेज एल्गोरिथम फॉर दिस बट आई मैम व्हेन आई यूज डायरेक्ट परसेंटेज साइन इट डज नॉट वर्क बट व्हेन यूज आई मल्टीप्लाई बाय 8 इनटू 100 देन इट वर्क व्हाई इट डज नॉट वर्क डायरेक्टली विद द परसेंटेज साइन.
Listen one thing, beta. This percentage is not that percentage which you are thinking. This percentage gives you the remainder. You know quotient remainder thing in mathematics?
What you want to ask, I am not understanding.
Okay, I will tell you. Wait a second. ये सुप्रिया योर एरर इज इजंट सॉल्वड येट ना. सुप्रिया
हेलो मैम
एरर सॉल्व और नॉट.
नहीं हो रहा सॉल्व. हम ए सेंटेंस ए फर्स्ट लाइन में एरर आ रहा है. ए इक्वल्स टू 10 जो मैंने लिखा है उसमें.
ओके डू वन थिंग शेयर योर स्क्रीन विद मी. For the ones who have done that arithmetic operators one, I have not received the codes. Only one code I have received, that is from Dakshaini. Where are the rest one? Okay, that's very good. That's pretty good, sir, Ms. Leela, sir.
Thank you.
Great, Apoorv. Very good. Yeah. Supri, open that only. Okay, erase all the code. Write it again. And don't write this one. If it comes automatically, then only write one. Otherwise, don't write it. Okay, so now I got the code from Shrayashi. Very good. That's very nice. Tanish, great, well done. Then I got code from Keitha, that's very nice. Ma'am, I'm
joining. How do you send the code? Miss, how do you send the code?
Okay, so Rishi, what you need to do is that the code which you have written in Google Colab, just copy whole code and share it in the comment box of this meeting. Got the answer, Supriya?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now you got that. What's the problem? If this 1, 2, 3 things come automatically, then let it be. Otherwise, don't write these things. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, cool. Okay, Hansraj, no problem. You can do it afterwards, or you can use the online compiler link which I have given to you yesterday, and Rakesh sir has also mentioned that link. Now let's move to our second thing, that is our second operators, which I was telling about the assignment operators. So now the assignment operators are plus equal to, minus equal to, multiply.
Excuse me, ma'am, you are not audible.
Yeah. Just a second. Now audible now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, yes, ma'am. Now we are going to see the assignment operators. Now, what are assignment operators? These are plus equal to, minus equal to, multiply equal to, divide equal to, percent equal to, and double star equal to. Hello, am I audible, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Audible,
yes,
but ma'am. Screen is not. Can you share the screen once again?
Rakesh, sir? Rakesh, sir.
Yes, I'm here. Tell me.
Yeah, please share the screen once again. Some of them are not able to see.
Oh, but here it's showing it on present.
Yeah, okay, actually, sorry. I am also.
You mean on any desk or here? Which one?
Yeah, I need the both one. Here also and on any desk also.
Oh, any desk also, you lost the connection.
Yeah. Yes. Just a second. Wait, is the request coming to you? Okay. I need. Except... Okay, it's okay. And
yeah, now I think it should be right. Go ahead.
Yeah, it is fine. Thank you so much.
Continue.
So I have told you about the assignment operators, that they are plus equal to, minus equal to, multiply equal to, divide equal to, percent equal to, and double star equal to, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Guys, are you listening me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, please tell me that yes or no. Okay, so now here is a shortcut and a long example for both the things. The shortcut to write that, if you write A is equal to A plus B. Okay, so the shortcut for writing is that A plus is equal to B. Now let me tell you this with the example. Let me open that collaborative notebook, and here, okay. Now let's take another example for assignment. Like, I have written A is equal to 11. Next, what I do here is that I write A is equal to minus equal to 1. And then next, I write print and bracket in A, small a. So now what does this line means here? A minus is equal to 1. Let me explain this using a comment. That here A is equal to A minus 1. So basically A minus is equal to 1. This is the shortcut for writing A is equal to A minus 1. And now the thing what happens here is that we have given a value A is equal to 11. And after that, it here happens is that A is equal to 11 minus 1. that is 10, and after that we get the output of A as 10 here. Let me run this and let's see, we have got the output here as 10. So basically this is the assignment operator, how we use it. Now in this assignment operator, there are things like plus equal to, minus equal to, multiply equal to, divide equal to, percent equal to, and double star. So basically what is this double star? Double star is used for the power options, like power of something. So for that we use it here. So I hope by the time you all must have written the code which I have written here for assignment operators, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Written?
Yes, ma'am.
The code is running?
Yeah, we got the output.
Okay. That's very nice. And what about rest of you? Did you get the output?
Yes, miss.
Okay, Ria.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Keitha.
Yes, ma'am.
That's good, Tanish. Okay, let's move further. I hope by the time you all have written the codes, right? Now, what is next? Next are the comparison operators. Since your childhood classes, you all must have heard of greater than, equal to than, equal and then less than. These all symbols you all must have heard from your younger, earlier classes, right? You all must be familiar with these things.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So basically the comparison operator is this only, that here are six types of operators in which is, now double equal to means that this is equal to this. Like two, if we write two, equal to two. So it will give us a output as true, because this condition which we have written, that 2 is equal to 2, is true. So we will get the output as true. So basically how is this equal to works is that we need to compare two numbers, that is this number equal to this number, okay? Then after that, is this number not equal to this number? Then what we use is that greater sign, less than, greater than or equal to, and less than or equal to. So basically these are the comparison operators which we use in Python. Now let's, next example for is that, let's write P is equal to 70. Let's take this example. And after that, let's write Q is equal to 100. Next, let's write some conditions here. If P is less than Q. Okay, just a second. Here, if P is less than Q, after that colon, enter, yahan par we write print P is lesser, and what next we write here is the else condition. I will tell you about the if else conditions today only, but let's do this code first. And what I write here is that print Q is greater. Don't go over the spellings. Okay, let me correct it. G-R-E-A-T-E-R. Okay. So what is this? We have written here. We have written yes.
Ma'am, third line I think P is less than Q. Okay.
Yeah, P is less than Q. So now let me explain this code to you, that I have taken a variable that is named as P, which is equal to 70. And the second variable which I have taken is Q, and that is equal to 100. Now, I write a condition here that if P is less than Q, if the value which is stored in P is less than the value which is stored in Q, then print me that P is greater. Otherwise, and what the next thing I have used here is that else condition, else print Q is greater. So basically if and else, these are the conditions which we use, and okay, so these are the conditions which we use for comparison between two numbers. So by the time, I hope you all have written this. Yes or no? Yeah.
Then the previous code
writing is an error.
Okay, Srayashi, what's the
double
error?
Quotations are needed.
Saying that int object is not callable.
Yes, Keitha, double quotes are needed here. Apply them, please. Yes, Srayashi, what's your error?
Then it's showing type error.
Type error, okay. Just tell me one thing, that have you given a space between minus and equal to?
No, ma'am.
You have given or not?
No, ma'am.
You haven't given that.
No, ma'am, the error is showing in the last sentence, ma'am, the print one.
Okay, and share the code. Share the code in the comment box.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, it should be within quotes, right?
What? P is lesser and Q is greater, right?
Yes, ma'am. P is lesser and Q is greater.
Yeah. It should be in quotes. Actually, I'm using AnyDesk, so it is a little bit slow. So that's why. Please, you all put that semi-quotes here. Completed the code?
Ma'am, there is also showing an error.
In which one?
Ma'am, syntax error.
In which
P less than Q.
Okay, just a second, Tanish. So, Srayashi, what's your error is here is that you have written A minus equal to 1. Just separate this. A, give a gap between A and minus.
Am I try again?
Okay, hello, try that, Tanish. Yes.
Is this if and else loop?
Yeah. It is if and else.
I think many students don't know here about
what?
Loops.
Yes, Rishi, many of the students don't know here about the loop. So I'm going to cover this loops in the today's session only. But here I need to use this condition, this conditional operator. So that's why I'm telling about the if else conditions here. Is that fine, Rishi?
Okay.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, Rishi.
Ma'am, now it's showing syntax error.
Okay, so see one thing, listen here, you have written this 3 apart from 2. See the line that 1 and 2 are in a line and 3 is not in that line. You are seeing that thing or not? Srayashi?
Yes, ma'am.
Is that clear?
Ma'am, I'm not getting.
I'm not getting it.
Okay, just a second, Danish. Let me solve first. Srayashi is out. Okay, Srayashi, share your screen, please.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Dakshani, your code is absolutely correct. Very good. Very well done. But yeah, this is the thing which I was saying to you now.
Yes, I think you didn't write quotation in your one.
What?
You know, when you did print, P is lesser. You never put quotations in it.
Just a second. Let me do that. Now, is it fine, Rishi?
Yes, miss.
Okay, Swayashi, that's now what open that. I was saying that don't give this space between minus and 11. Just combine minus and 11. Here in the next line. Just don't give space. Now give space after equal to. And now run that code. So what is it writing that int object is not callable?
Yes, ma'am.
In the first code also it was showing something similar, ma'am. Yeah.
Okay, let me check that. Just take it a little bit down. Do one thing, make them in semi-quotes. Keep this A inside semi-quotes.
This one?
Yeah. Okay, Hansraj, your code is fine. I guess it must be running, right? Yes, Rishi, your code is absolutely correct. Yes, Rishi, your code is absolutely correct. Then Ria, PQS is lesser, A is greater. Ria, do one thing that try to do this thing that if you are taking the variables P and Q, then here also in the print statement, write P is lesser and P is greater. Don't take the different variables inside these print statements, okay? Ria, is that okay? Okay, fine. Yes, did you do that? No, just do one thing that after this print, apply those brackets and inside that brackets, apply quotes and then inside it, write A. Yes. And just mix this print with the brackets. Don't give the space here. Yeah. Again, that type error A is equal to 11, A minus is equal to 1.
Rishi, don't have quotations for variables, right?
Yeah, Rishi, but there the error was coming that int object is not callable. So that's why I was trying to check that was this the error or not.
Okay, miss.
Okay, Srashi, just hold on a second.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so I see, let's solve your error afterwards because I need to check it. Like, we need to connect on any desk and then I need to check it that what's the error here.
Okay, ma'am.
Next, who was having that error?
Ma'am, I have. Ma'am, it is saying that name lesser is not defined.
Name letter is not defined. Send name your lesser. Code. Send the code in the comment box, Tanish.
Ma'am, I also send it.
Okay, this one. Okay, so for this, you need to write a small p. You have written capital P here in the print statement. And inside P
no,
is
ma'am,
lesser.
No, ma'am, I write not capital. Ma'am, in PC, I note I capital.
Okay, so keep this P is lesser inside the semi quotes, double quotes.
And Q
is greater also in the double quotes. Just see here as I have done. This I have written in the inside these, na?
Okay, ma'am.
Do it and then tell me. And all of you other have done the code, right? Okay, Keetha, it's absolutely fine. Mr. Bhanushali, it's also fine. Manas Bhanushali, that's totally fine.
It's done, ma'am.
Correct? Okay. Yeah, that's very true, Mr. Leela. That's very correct. Well done. So now we have completed this arithmetic, this comparison operator also. Let's move to forward. Now, let's talk about some logical operators. What are logical operators? No, let's see. Logical operator is, you can say, in OR and. Firstly, we need to focus on these two operators, that is OR and. So basically for OR, what we do is that here the logical operator OR means that you have written two variables and two things. Okay, Mr. Bhanushali, I will send that doc to you, fine? So you have written X and Y, two variables, and the OR symbol is the straight dash. See on your keyboards, above the enter key, there is a key in where there is slash and a straight bar. You all found that?
Yes, ma'am.
So yes, that ma'am. Straight key is the OR symbol, which we are going to use here. And what this OR does is that it multiplies two things.
Sorry, ma'am, no. Nothing is showing.
Yes, who is that?
Ma'am, nothing is showing. Ma'am, it's me, Tanish. Ma'am, nothing is showing, ma'am.
Tanish, try to refresh your page. Is the screen visible to everyone else?
Yes, ma'am, it is.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Try to refresh your page, whosoever is not able to see this. So basically the OR operator, what it does here is that it tries to add the two X and Y variables. It does not multiply. It adds these two variables. And the work of AND operator is that it tries and does the multiplication of these two operands which are present with it. Now let's take an example. With the example, you will be able to understand more. Just a second. Let me go to the collaboratory. Okay. So now next, what we are going to code is that let's take a variable which is equal to 10 and another b variable which is equal to 20. Clear? And after that, write, print, and use these semicolons a, and now apply that OR sign here. B is, and after that we can put colon. It's totally upon you, because the thing which we write inside the semicolons, it's totally upon you that whatever you can write, it's the thing which will come in the output, which the user will see when your output will be displayed. You neither write anything inside the semicolons, it's not a problem. You directly print A or B here. That's totally fine. So now after that I will write, here we will apply comma, and then A, we will use the OR symbol, which I have told you that it is there above the enter key in your laptops. So we will use OR and B. Clear? Write the code and then run this code. After running, what I told is that OR operators does the addition of the both numbers. So what it is giving us as the output is that A or B is 30. So basically what this does is that it added 20 and 10, and we got the output as 30. Clear, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so write the codes and send these to me. Rishi, is now the screen visible to you?
No, ma'am.
Try to refresh your page.
Ma'am?
Yeah. Yeah, tell.
Excuse me, ma'am.
I am getting some error in the previous code.
Okay, Hansraj, share that code in the comment box.
Okay, ma'am.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, Rayashi.
Ma'am, it's again showing error.
Which code?
Ma'am, the one you shared just now.
Okay, share the code. Share the code in the comment box.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so Hansraj, your error is that whenever we use if and else condition, so after if there is some space of some tab. So have you entered that space?
No, ma'am. I'm doing.
So I'll do that. Okay, Manas, I will explain you once more. Just see here. See, we have taken two variables, that is A is equal to 10 and then B is equal to 20. We have assigned two values, 10 and 20, to two variables A and B. After that, now only we have seen the use of OR operator. So what OR operator does is that it adds the two variables. So the variable A and B, we have assigned values 20 and 10. So when we are writing print A or B is and colon and after that comma, we are doing the main operation, that is for the OR operator. So I have written A and this single line is the sign for the OR operator and after that B. So when we run this code, the OR operators adds the both values 10 and 20 and gives us a output of 13. Now, is it clear to you, Harsh? No, that was Manas. Is it clear to you, Manas? Okay, very good. Now, Srayashri, what's your error? A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20, print A or B is, comma, A or B. Okay, so... Just a second. Yes.
The error is int object is not callable.
So I don't know why you guys are facing this int error is not callable. This type error. Okay, Srayashi, we will solve this your int callable error after this session.
Okay, ma'am.
I need to take your AnyDesk ID and then I need to run the codes on your machine.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, Keeta, it's fine. It's good. Next, Dakshini, that's very nice. Okay, Dakshini, here you have covered the thing which I was coming to, that you have taken the AND operator also and you found that the output which we are getting from A and D is wrong. Why? Have you noticed that thing? Did you got the wrong output? Because the AND thing does the multiplication and why we are not getting the multiplication output, that is 200 here, we are only getting the 0. Anyone who knows this answer in the class?
Ma'am, could be bitwise operator does
For 10, 1010.
Yeah.
15. And for 20, it's 1, 2.
What was the question? I'm sorry, I was just typing.
Okay. So the question is, check in the comment box that Dakshini has sent a code which she has written, and in that she had used a print statement. She has used a operator and also. So why this AND operator is giving the output as 0, not the desired output that is 200? Why? So basically this is a question for you all, which you all will search and revert me back either on the Slack or tomorrow in the session. I want this answer from each one of you. Then only I will tell its answer. Right?
Sure, ma'am. We'll check.
Sure, clear to everyone?
Which answer?
This that why when we are using the AND operator, why we are not getting the proper output, which is the desired output. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Okay, Supriya, your answer is correct. Then Keetha, your answer is connect. Okay, Rishi. Manas, your answer, your code is right.
Yeah, yes. Ma'am, yes. For AND operator, the both operands should be same. Then only it give the output.
Okay. Fine. Got that. Good. Who was that? Can you please tell me your name?
Yeah, it's Dakshini.
Okay, Dakshini.
And for OR operator, this or this means either either the operand or n of 2 give a output. For AND operation, both operands should be there to put besides the operator.
Okay, Dakshini, your answer is correct. But except Dakshini, tomorrow I want the answers from everyone else. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now let's move to our next operator and take it as just a second. Logical, we have completed. Now there are two operators left, identity and membership operators. So now let me tell you about the identity operator, that in this operator there are two things, that is and is not. Let me tell you this with an example here. Just a second, it would be more clear. So what we are going to do is there that
ma'am,
we are going to
share your screen, ma'am.
But it is already shared.
But
is
not...
everyone able to see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
The ones who are not able, please refresh your page. And do one thing, just pin on Rakesh sir's screen. When you will click on the screen, there would be an option for pin and unpin. Just pin that and then you will be able to see the screen. Okay, so we have taken a variable x is equal to x and assigned as 10 here. Now, what the next thing comes here is that I had taken another variable z and
not
assigned a variable. Yes.
Your screen is not showing.
Yes, ma'am. I refreshed the page, but I can't see your screen.
Have you pinned the screen? Rakesh sir's screen, not mine.
Oh.
Actually, my laptop is having some problem. It's again hanging because whenever I'm sharing the screen, so Rakesh sir is sharing the screen. Did you got that now? Okay, so what I have done here is that I have taken a variable x and assigned the value as 10 here. Now next I have taken another variable z and assigned the value of x into that variable z. So now the x and the z, both variables contains the same value, that is 10. This thing is clear to everyone?
Yes,
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, next, what we are going to write is that we are going to write a print statement, and after that, what I'm going to do is that X is big. So from here, the membership and the identity operators. Presently, we are seeing the identity operator. After this, we will see the membership. So these two are the operators which give the output as true or false. Clear? So basically, it will give the output true when both the values are both the variables are having the same values. Now understand this thing as a simple English sentence that we have given the value of x 10. After that, I have assigned the value of x into z. So now x and z both are having the same values, that is 10, right? So after that, if we write in print statement that x is z, so this statement must be true because the x and z, these both are having the same values, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So now the output which we should get here is true. Here, and we got that true output because we have used the membership operator is here and our condition is true. If we use is not here. Is not. And now I run the
ma'am. Yes, sorry, yes, for disturbance, but your screen is not showing it, ma'am. Still.
Okay. Do one thing. Find Rakesh sir here.
Yes, ma'am. Rakesh, I appeared, but not showing still.
All other, you are able to see the screens?
Are you able to see?
Yes, yeah, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am. I can.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Better you can reconnect once again.
Yeah, just try to reconnect once again and pin Rakesh's screen. Okay, so did you all got the use of membership operator? That how do we do membership operator?
Yes, ma'am, we got.
Wrote the code or not?
Yes, ma'am.
We have written, ma'am.
Okay. Everyone has written. I'm only getting 2-3 responses here. And we have total 22. Why?
Ma'am, I got the answer.
Okay, that's very nice. Okay, that's great. Dakshaini, Mr. Bhanushali, Mr. Leela, Riya, I got output okay, Geetha. Tanish, that's very nice. Ipshita, okay. Okay, fine, fine, fine. So now we have checked the membership operator. Now what comes next is our, no, we have checked the identity operator and next is our membership operator. The only thing changes here is in and not in, but one more difference is there. Now let me make the screen down a little. Okay, here what we do is that we take a string. Now what is our string? A string is the collection of characters, you can say. And remember my one thing, keep this thing in mind always, that always strings are written using semi quotes. It's not the thing whether you write any character inside a semicolon or you write any number inside a semicolon. The thing which you write inside a semicolon always becomes a string. Let me tell you example for that first. If you write apple here inside, it is a string. If you write 1, 2, 3 here, it is a string. Got that point? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So for membership operators, I have told you that there are two things, in and not in. It is just similar to the identity operator. So what I am doing here is that I have taken a string, I have taken a variable x and assigned a string to it. Now next, again, I am doing the same thing which I have done there, that print, then in semicolons apple in x. So what it is going to see that is x having apple here. So is the x variable having apple? Yes or no?
Yes, no.
So what would be the output here?
False. It's true.
Who was the false one? No. I'm not. Don't try here, bacha. What's the false? Please come up. Let me clear your doubt here. That's not any problem that you have given a wrong answer. I always appreciate the answers, whether it is right or wrong. Okay, don't tell your name. Wait, listen my thing. That apple in X. Apple in X. It means that X variable has a string stored in that which is named as apple. So it is saying apple in X. In X we have apple. So the statement which comes here is that apple in apple. So yes, apple in apple. So this condition is true. And we will get the output here as true. Clear? Clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, please do it for in and not in. Fast and send the code to me in the comment box. So here we completed the topic of operators in Python. Now, whatever doubts are here for operators, please come upon and ask me all the doubts. Then we will move to second type, that is types of error which we face during our Python programs. Okay, Dakshani. Great. Very, very, very well done. Guys, are you typing? Okay, Ria, F23, G is equal to F. Print F is G, F is not G. F is G into F is going to print banana in A. Okay, Ria, very good. Okay, Kita, that's right. Okay, Srayashi, very nice. Okay, Supriya, very good. So finally here we have completed our topic of types of operators. Very good, Mr. Bhanushali. Great, Hansraj. Very good, Manas. Okay. So our topic for types of operators is completed now. Next, types of operators is completed. Now we are moving towards the types of operators. Types of errors. Fine, should I move? Great, Tanish.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Sir, I'm sending you some PPTs. So I hope by the time everyone has completed all the programs which I am telling you here, right? Right?
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello?
Ma'am, but there are errors.
Yeah, any problem? Hello?
No, sir, no problem. I was saying that I am sending you some things.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, on where? The Slack only. On the Slack.
Yeah, so you can operate, right?
Yeah.
You can just go back from here. You can operate like this.
Okay.
Are you are still there on any desk or you're not there?
Yeah, I'm there.
So operate it. Go ahead.
Okay. Yeah, so what were the errors which you were telling? Who was the error one? Who is facing the error, I mean?
From me.
Can I have a name, please?
I'm Srayashi.
Okay, Srayashi. Okay, yeah, there were two. One Srayashi and one more. We will connect after this session, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
I will check all the things which you are facing. So, I hope that all of you have written all the quotes which I have told. So, there in the meeting, there are 22 people. So, I want all the 22 collaboratory notebooks on the Slack group only, right? Till today evening. Yes? Guys, reply, yes, please.
Okay, ma'am.
We give all our codes in the Slack group.
Okay, I will tell you that, just a second. Here is your collaboratory notebook. When you click here on share, okay? So when you will click here, you will a box will appear, and here you need to see that change link to, like you will do this, change link to anyone, and then copy the link and paste it on the Slack. Okay.
Okay, miss.
Clear? Okay. So okay, I want all clear. I want all the 22 links here. Okay. Now let's move to errors. That what are the types of errors which we face in our programming? Let me move. Okay, the first error is the syntax error. Now, syntax error are the most basic types of error. They arise when the Python parser is unable to understand a line of code. Most syntax error are typos, incorrect indentation, or incorrect arguments. So now let me tell. Here some of you, I got one code here in which there was minus and equal to apart from each other. Remember, we got a code in the comment box in which minus and equal to were apart from each other, right?
Yes, ma'am, it was.
Yes, ma'am.
So that was a type of syntax error. See, if you miss a colon, if you miss a bracket anywhere, if you miss any semicolons, so all those errors come under syntax error. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the first example which we are seeing here, just leave all the things you don't know while, you don't know if, you know, don't know else. Leave all the things. The thing which I am telling you here is that we need to maintain an indentation everywhere. What does this indentation means? Indentation means a proper gap between the loops or between the code which we are writing. So here what I see is that if and else are written in a proper code, proper line, but elif is moved forward without if and else. So this is an syntax error. Clear? If elif and else, all the three should be in a single line. So that is why we are facing an error that is called syntax error, that an indent does not match any outer indentation level. Clear? Clear, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No?
Okay, let me explain here in the Google Colab. Let me open it. Okay, so now let's take the example. I have taken a variable a is equal to 2, and then I have taken b is equal to 2. Oh, no, b is equal to 3. Then I write the condition if a greater than b, and I print it as print in bracket A is greater. This thing is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
And then I do here is that I write else here and then semicolon and then I print B is greater. So here the indentation is wrong. See this, we have written if here, just after here. And where is our else going? It is going a far apart from if. These all things are not in a single line, if and else, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is the syntax error. Clear?
Yes, ma'am. Identification error.
Yeah. Indentation error. Very true. So basically, this is our syntax error. Now, if you miss this colon here, if you miss it, it will show you an error. Okay, Mr. Bhanushali, I got that. I got your link. So this, if we miss the colon after if, we will face an error that is called a syntax error. Clear? So basically, this was a syntax error, which we will see afterwards. And I'm not going to run this. Okay, let's run it once. And see, it will say some error type thing. Okay, syntax error, invalid syntax. So now, if I put the semicolon here, and now, again, I run it. Okay, sorry. Again, I run, I will get the output as B is greater. Okay? Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, next. Moving to next, we have the logical errors. Now, logical errors are the type of error in which you will not get that you have error in this line or invalid syntax or something like this. You will not get this, but you will not get the desired output which you want. Let me explain you this with an example. Now see this very okay. So now I'm going to tell you one more thing here. Keep an eye here that I write float and then after that input and bracket enter a number. So what is this float here? Can any one of you tell me what is this float?
Single precision value.
Yeah, that's right. So basically float is called a data type. So data type, what is a data type? The data types are like the type which we give. We give integers, we give floats, we give a string. So basically all these are called our data types. What type of data we are giving to our user? Clear? And
okay.
After that, this float is our data type. And after that, when we want that our user should take input from us, like in the previous examples, we were giving the values that A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3. And now we want that our user should ask us that enter a number. So for that, we need to write a statement like this here. What we do is that, so here I have taken float. You can take int also. Int is the integer data type. Clear? We will see this in the today's session, but let me tell you here that float is a type, data type, and we take these data types. Why? Because we want that our user should enter a number. Clear, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt?
Yes, ma'am.
Regarding that, how to take the output? Okay. So I have taken this x is equal to float. Yes.
And this number may be a decimal.
Yeah, float is a decimal value.
Okay.
And int is an integer value. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we have taken two values, x and y here. and we have assigned that float input enter a number. So our user will enter a number. So here we have not initialized any single number to a variable. We will ask our user that user should enter the number. Now I have taken another variable Z, and now I want the average of these two numbers. So I wrote x plus y by 2, and then I wrote print in bracket semicolon, and then average is comma Z. So basically we are going to take the input from the user and it will show us the average of two numbers. So just a second, let me do it a little down. Okay, now let's run this. When we will run, it will say that enter a number. Now I am going to enter here 2. It will say enter another number. I'm going to enter here 4. Now what are we going to get the output? We are giving the average as 4. So tell me, is the average right or wrong? What is the average for 4 and 2?
Number 3.
Yeah, it's 3. Very right. But we are getting it wrong. Why? What's the error here? Can anyone of you tell me?
Brackets.
Brackets in x, y, plus y.
Very true. Very true. So what we need to do here is that we need to put the brackets after, I mean, we need to put x plus y inside the brackets. So this was a logical error. Now you got the point that what is a logical error?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now we will get the correct, that is 3.0. Clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Karan, that's right. You missed the Bodmer's rule, x plus y in brackets. Okay, Karan, okay. So now have you all written this code? Should I move forward?
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone written the code? Yeah, okay, I'm waiting. By the time, let me put my laptop on charging. It's getting to discharge. Okay. When you complete, please tell me that you have done, so I will move forward.
I've completed.
Okay. Thanks. That's great. Okay, so should I move?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, next what we are going to cover is the keywords and identifiers. Okay, so just a second, let me open. Okay, just a second. this one. So now we are going to see that what are keywords and what are identifiers. Okay. So now the definition and a simple definition for a keyword is that keyword are the reserved words. These are the words which are already there. So there are total 33 keywords in Python. So the things which we were using like if, else, and what we have used except if, else, we haven't used anything. So the if and else we were using, these all are the keywords. These are the reserved words which are already there. So all the other keywords except true, false, and none, all the other keywords are in the lower case. Now, what does this mean? That in true, false, and none, the first letter of all these three keywords are capital. And other than all the three words, all the other keywords are having the lowercase characters in that. Even the first character is also a lowercase character. Let me show you this thing. Let me move to another slide. Okay, so these are all 33 keywords which I was saying. False, you can see that false, none, and true. The starting three keywords have the first letter as capital, and other than that, all the other words, all the other keywords are not having their first letter as capital. Did you all notice this thing?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, I hope you got the idea that what are keywords? False, none, true, and class, continue, def, except, finally, for, if, else, lambda, pass, raise, return, while. All these are the keywords which we use in our Python programming. And next what comes is the identifiers. Now, identifiers are the words which we make, like we had made x is equal to something. So basically, what is this x? This x is, okay, this one. So basically, what was that x? That x was a identifier. Clear? Identifier are the words which we write. These are also called as, okay, so these are also called as variables. So name given to entities like class, function, variables, that helps to differentiate one entity from another. You have seen that we have used values p, q, x, a, b, y. So these all were the identifiers. Now we have used single identifiers, single words. There are some rules to write these identifiers. So the first rule for writing the identifier is that an identifier cannot start with a digit. Always an identifier can start only with an alphabet. Second, identifiers can be of any length. You can even write a one word identifier, and you can even write a hundred word identifier. That's totally upon your choice. You can take any length of the identifier. Now, the third and the most important thing which arises here is that keywords cannot be used. So why? We have heard that keywords, we have understand what are keywords. Any one of you tell me the definition for keywords which I have told right now.
The words which are already defined in the Python library.
Okay. Anyone else?
Reserved words.
Okay. So keywords cannot be used as the identifiers. We can't use true as an identifier. We can't use false. We can't use if as the identifiers. Now, fourth, special symbols on an order. What are special symbols? Special symbols are @, dollar, hash, star, percent, division, brackets. We can't use all these symbols in writing our identifier. The only symbol which is allowed in writing an identifier is underscore. Clear? We can use underscore either in the starting or in the last or in the middle of our identifier. It will not show us any error. But if you will use any other like exclamatory mark, @, hash, dollar, percent, plus, minus, in an identifier, it will show you an error. And identifiers can be combination of alphabets and numbers. But the thing that comes here is that identifier cannot start with a number. A number can be written in between the identifier. Like you can write ABC9 hash, not hash, underscore D. It would be true. But if you write 9ABC, it will show you an error because a number, an identifier cannot start with a digit. Did I make all the things clear to you? Any of the doubt in all these 5 rules?
No, miss.
No, ma'am.
Okay. So now,
ma'am?
Now, yes, ma'am. Yes.
Ma'am, I have no doubt in rules, but I am not completely understand what is identifier.
Okay. Okay, so what's your name?
Tanish, ma'am.
Tanish, you have written a recent code for x is equal to float input enter a number, right?
Yes, ma'am.
You have written?
Yes, ma'am.
So what is that x? X is an identifier. Clear?
Okay, ma'am.
Identifier, you can take it as identifier or you can take it as a variable. So identifier is a thing in which you store some value. Clear? You have written x, y, z, you had used p, q, you have used a, b. So all these are the identifiers. These are the words which you make to store something. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now next, if this thing is clear to you all, now I have some questions for you from identifiers, that why this identifier is a valid identifier and why this identifier is a not valid identifier. So the first one is that, let's leave this example of keywords. Just a second, let me send one more slide to show. Hold on. Till then, revise all the rules for identifiers. Okay, so this one. Now, here is a slide in which you are seeing some valid and some invalid identifiers, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So now let me check. Now, let me take some names and ask that why it is a valid identifier and why it is not a valid identifier. Firstly, I would want Mr. Hansraj, please come up and tell me that why AB10C is a valid identifier.
Ma'am, because it is starting with a number.
Okay. So you are right that in our identifier, we can. Yes, Hansraj, you are right. Hello, am I audible now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so yes, you are correct, Hansraj, because we can use the number in between an identifier. Okay, now next, who is there? Mr. Bhanushali.
Yes, miss.
Why 99 is not an invalid identifier?
It starts with a number.
Okay, so there's a rule that numbers are not allowed in the starting of an identifier. Very good. Now next we have Ipshita. Ipshita, can you unmute yourself? Okay, so tell me that ABC underscore DE, why is it is a valid identifier? Ipshita? Okay, let's. I hope I think that she is not able to speak or something. Let's leave it. No problem. Next, Mr. Karan Bhanushali. Please unmute yourself. Mr. Karan. Okay, no problem. No problem, Karan. Okay, Supriya, no problem. Ma'am, error. What error, Supriya?
Okay, ma'am, float. Yeah. इससे पहले जो आपने करवाया था उसमें average हम यहाँ पे error हो रहा है. Enter a number 2.
ओके ठीक है मैं अभी उसको एरर को देख रही हूँ पहले मैं क्वेश्चंस पूछ रही हूँ फिर आप अपने
एरर शी हैज एंटर अ नंबर राइट इट्स अ व्हेन आउट या मींस आई थिंक शी थॉट दैट इट्स मे बी द एरर
ओके सुप्रिया जस्ट होल्ड ऑन फॉर अ सेकंड लेट मी डिस्कस दिस आइडेंटिफायर्स क्वेश्चन लेट मी आस्क एंड देन आई यू कैन शेयर योर स्क्रीन आई विल टेल यू ओके So, who was the next? No problem for the poor networks one. Keetha, where are you? I had taken your name. Okay, Mr. Leela, can you please tell?
Which one? ABC underscore D?
Yeah.
It's starting with the alphabet. Okay. So, it's a valid identifier.
Okay. That's right. And okay, the single underscore is also used. You can start use this underscore in the starting also. Okay, now my last question too is to Rishi. Rishi.
Yes, miss.
Tell me that why this 4 is an invalid identifier.
Yes.
No problem. Because just a second. Okay. Yeah. Okay, Rishi, it's an invalid identifier because 4 is a keyword.
Miss.
Yeah.
Miss, why is x plus y invalid in identifier?
Okay, x plus y is an invalid identifier because I told that except underscore, we can't use any special symbol here. So we have used a plus sign here. So that is why it is an invalid identifier.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, welcome. So I hope this valid and invalid. Yes.
Miss, okay, I found out because it's for x and range, so it's a keyword.
Very good, Rishi. That's nice. So I hope you all have found that what are valid identifiers, what are invalid identifiers, and what is a keyword. Clear with all these concepts?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now next we are going to see what are data types. Okay. Now here, if I write one thing that print in bracket, I write type and I write 1, 2, 3. So can any one of you tell me that what would be the output for this?
Int.
How?
Ma'am, because I thought type of 1, 2, 3 is a data type of the number. So 1, 2, 3 is an integer. Maybe I don't know.
Yeah, you are correct. I guess Dakshini, right?
Yes, ma'am.
You are correct. Listen to one my thing that integer are the words which do not have any decimal thing. Clear? So if you write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 or any of these things, it doesn't have any decimal value in it. So it is an integer. And now the float things are, if you have any decimal value in it, it is treated as a float value. So I made this thing clear to you about the integer and the float values. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So just a second, these slides are just uploading. It will take a little 1 second. Okay, so the slides are uploaded now. Let me close this and this one. Okay, so now we are going to see data types and typecasting. Just hold on a second. Okay. So I hope this data type slide is clear to you all.
Yes, ma'am.
You are able to see, right? Yes, so data ma'am. Types, okay. Data types are the variable, data types. Variables can hold values and values have data types. Now, recently only I told you about variables and identifiers. So what is their work? They hold some value, they take some value. And what type of value is that which is known as data type? Let me tell you that there are Python data types are numeric, dictionary, boolean, set and sequence. So here in numeric, we have three types, integer, complex number and float. So basically, we focus on two things that are integer and float values. And then we see some things like dictionary, sets, and we will see this here in the maybe in tomorrow's session for this. So basically, what are data types? Data types are the types of values which we have in our program. Integer is a data type, string is a data type, float is a data type. So I hope I made it clear to you that what are the data types. And then next, just a second.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes, yes. All okay?
Yeah, yeah, all fine, all fine.
So I think it is for, so shall we proceed tomorrow or you want to continue some more time?
Yeah, actually in the starting I joined a little late, so let me just finish this topic and then I will close up.
Okay, is it fine with the student?
Yeah, if they want to continue.
Yes, ma'am, it's fine.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, fine.
Yes, ma'am.
So, okay, so if you all want to go and have water or take a 2-3 minute break, you can. Or should I continue?
Yeah, yeah.
Continue. So now we have seen that what are data types and what are the types. Now we are moving towards the typecasting. Now typecasting is a very important topic. Please pay a little bit more attention from the previous topics. Okay, so Hansraj, please close your mic. It's creating a little bit of disturbance here. Okay, thank you so much. So typecasting is conversion of one data type to another. So see, if we have a float data type and we want to convert it into integer, so we can using a thing that is known as typecasting. So now typecasting is of two types, implicit typecasting and explicit typecasting. Let me move forward and tell you about the implicit typecasting. So implicit type casting is a type of conversion in which the data type is converted to other automatically. Now, here is a one concept which comes is the lowest rank and the highest rank concept. Here you see a chart in the left hand side where it is lowest rank and towards the highest rank. So lowest rank is of the cash or int, then integer. So see one thing, don't pay attention towards all the things here. The thing which I am saying that in this chart, just see about the integer, float, integer and float now only. So you saw what that integer has a lowest rank than float. Now let's move to an example which is given here is that num int. So it is a valid identifier, right? Because we have used two words, that is num, and we have separated it with a underscore, and after that I have used int. Clear? Num int is equal to 123 and num flow is equal to 1.23. Then what I have done is that I have taken a new variable num new, which is equal to num int plus num flow. Clear? So what we are doing here is that we are adding these num int and num flow, whatever the values we have in this 123 and 1.23. We are adding those two values and storing these values in a new variable, new identifier, that is num new. Till now it is clear to you all?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, so after that, when I print data type of num int, I have told you about the data type. When I'm going to print the data type of num integer, the way to check any data type of any variable is that you need to write type and in brackets you need to write that variable name or any of the number or a string. So this is the way to check any of the data type. Now abhi we will do the practical, but let me explain this example to you. So by the same, we have checked the type of num int and we have checked the type of num flow. So now move to the right hand side image where there is written data type of num int is class int. So basically, whenever the type of a variable and we get the output, we get the brackets and inside it is written class int. Okay, so this class is written why? I will tell you this thing when we will cover the class topic in our session. Okay. So the data type for num int and num flow, we have checked that class integer and class float. Num integer is an integer data type and num float, we have given a floated type. By this thing, you all must be clear. Now, what comes next here is that we have written print value of num new. Num new. So in num new, what we have given is that num int plus num flow. So we will get the summation of 123 plus 1.23. So that is 124.23. So in the output, which is the right hand side, we have got value of num new is equal to 124.23. Now pay attention towards the last line. Here it is written that print data type of num new and in bracket type or bracket mein num new likha. We have written num new. And in the output, check the last output where it is written that data type of num new. In bracket, it is written class float. Now, here comes the role of implicit type conversion. We have given an integer and a float value. And we are getting the final data type as float. Why? Because of the lowest and the highest ranks. So here what comes is that integer has a lowest rank than float. So the whatever data type is having the highest rank, it will go and it will have that data type in the final output. Is my thing clear to you, or I will explain it once more, because this is a very important thing.
Ma'am, please explain it again.
Okay.
Once more.
Okay, sure. See, what I have done is that, okay, let me zoom. Can I zoom it a little? Yeah.
Om Bhanushali can't come in the meeting for some reason.
Okay, no problem. We can see the. Okay. So listen it once more. That we have taken two variables, num int, which is equal, which we have assigned the value 1, 2, 3 into the num int, and after that, I have assigned the value 1.23 to the num flow. Clear? After that, I have taken a new variable, that is num new, which is equal to num int plus num flow. I have added the both the things. Clear? Now, if I print the data type of num int and print the data type of num float, it will show no error and it will give us the type for that. For the type of num int, we have integer data type, and for the type of flow, we have float data type. By this time, it is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
All of you clear?
Ma'am,
yes, ma'am, it's clear.
Okay, I will give you example. Just let me first complete this one. I will give you an example. Okay?
Okay.
So after that, now see the print statement. What we have written, that value for num new is equal to num new. We have added both the values of num int and num flow, which were having 1, 2, 3 plus 1.23. We have added them, and in the output we got 124.23. Now, when we are going to check the data type of num new is the variable in which we have stored the addition value of num int and num flow. So when we check the data type of num new, we get the output as class float. We get a float data type, because now see in the left hand side this chart, which is made to the lowest rank till the highest rank. Here, see where is integer and where is float. When you will check this, you will get that integer has lowest rank than float. Clear? Are you guys seeing this chart?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the data type which has lowest rank will not be considered, and the data type which has the highest rank, it will be considered, and the type of num new, the data type which will num new will have, it is float, because float has highest rank than integer values. Now clear? So the data type which will have the highest rank, that data type will be considered in the final output. Clear, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
So now let me take one more example, and then I will tell you this thing. Just a second. Okay. Now let me open that Google Colab notebook. Let me erase this. Okay. So here let's take a is equal to 1. Clear? And then let's take b is equal to 2.0. Next, let's take C is equal to A plus B. Now, what we are going to print here is that print data type, and then comma, and then I will write type of A. So here we are going to check that which type is our variable A is having which type. Clear? Clear till now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Next, we are checking for B. And now, what I am doing here is that print value value of C colon and after that comma C and then print just a second, where are my semicolons data type and after that comma or type bracket mein C. So have you all written this code? And now I'm not going to run this code. Whosoever has written this code, run it and send the output in the chat box fast. Okay, that's very nice, Mr. Leela. That's very nice, and the answer is correct also. Are you writing, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, do that. Written. Okay, so let me see that whosoever has given. Okay, Dakshani, 1, 2.2. Okay, that's fine. That's totally fine. Very good. Okay, Apoor, very good. Ria, very nice. Okay, so I hope you all have got the idea of the implicit type conversion. Now, let's move to the explicit type conversion. That what is explicit type conversion? So this is Slack. Okay, just a second. Let me open it. Rakesh, sir. Rakesh, sir.
Hello. Yes, sir, yes, I'm here.
Sir, the Slack is not opening from my side. Can you please open that?
Yes, this one, right? Yeah. What is this? What is happening?
Yeah, I don't
what
know.
What is this red? Okay, anyway, fine. Don't worry.
Okay. So by the time you all have...
Do you have something else?
Yeah, just one slide. So please click on this blue slide. I don't know why it's not working from my side. Yeah, this last one.
So, Sambhavi, which one?
Yeah, this last one. Explicit type conversion. Blue one.
Right?
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Okay. What is this? All right.
Just a second. I don't know what is this. How did this come?
Okay, we'll see. So after just see okay. This and then we'll see okay. What to do.
Okay. Okay, so now our next topic of discussion is explicit type conversion. I hope you all got that. Okay, Tanish, that's very nice. Dakshaini, Apoorv, Riya, Tanish, Mr. Bhanushali, Keitha, and Hansraj. Very well done, very well done. Now, our last topic of today's session is explicit type conversion. So, in implicit, we have seen that the data type changes according to the lowest and the highest ranks. But in explicit type conversions, we need to convert one data type to another data type on our own. Read this definition that in this type of conversion, user has to convert the data type from one to another. Let me take an example for that. Let's move to our collaboratory. This one, okay. And let's create a new cell here. Let me give you an example by writing the code only because it's okay. So now let's take an example for the explicit type conversion. I am going to take a variable and assign it a value as 1. Next, I am going to take another variable b and assign it a value 10. Now, any one of you tell me which type of data type I have assigned in the B variable, which is this data type?
String.
Yeah, correct. That's a string. Now, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to print the type of A and the type of B. So I simply write type A and then I write print bracket me type B. So here we have seen the type of A and B. Now, here, tell me one thing, that you have written a value in integer and you have taken a value in a string. If you add both of them, will you get any output or will you get any error? Can a string and an integer be added both together?
No.
Yes. It no, would ma'am. Give, yeah, very true. It would give us an error. So here comes the role of the explicit type casting. What we need to do in explicit type casting is that we need to change that variable into integer only. So we need to change B into integer type. So for that, I am again taking the same variable B and I am writing B is equal to int and in bracket B. So basically this is the syntax for writing a explicit type conversion that we need to take the same variable which we need to convert in another data type. After that, in we need to take the data type in which we want to convert our variable. So here I want to change the variable b into integer data type. So I had taken the variable b, which is equal to, I have written here int, and in bracket I have written b. So it means that change the b variable into integer format. Clear this thing? Or any doubt?
Clear, ma'am.
Everyone clear?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Guys, listen, this is the very, very important thing, like conversion. If you get any code and there you ask that you have a string, you have a float variable, you have integer, so how would you add all these things? So for that, you would be needing explicit type conversion. So this is the basic syntax for doing an explicit type conversion. And after that, I will write, I will take a variable sum, which is equal to a plus b, and then I will print sum. And after that, I will also check one thing, that I will check what is the data type or of our sum variable. Clear? So for that, I write print in bracket type and after that of sum. Now enter, and what we got an output here is that firstly, we have printed the type for A, that is integer. Secondly, we have printed the type for B, that is a string. After that, we got the output. After that, what happened here is that we did the explicit type casting in the line number 5. We converted the string into an integer. And after that, I taken a variable and added A plus B. And after that, print the sum. And then print the type of sum. So we got the sum as 11, and now check that what's the type. Now we have done the explicit type conversion, so our final type is integer. Clear, guys?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so great, Rishi, great, Mr. Bhanushali, great, Geetha. So I hope by the time, have you all written this code or not? Very well done, Riya. Very well done. Great, Manas. Great, Dakshaini. So this is our second class only, and I have remembered some of the names also here. Because you all are very much interactive and very much constant in replying and writing the codes. Like, it's very, very good, very good. I appreciate all your efforts in this. Great, Rishi. Very nice, Dakshaini. Mr. Bhanushali, very great. Okay, so I hope you all have written all the codes, whatever I have told you today. And we have practiced some coding today. Now, the ones who were saying yesterday that I don't know coding and how will I proceed in that, do you find Python a little bit simple after attending today's class or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Great to hear this. Great Sayashri. Great Tanish. Very well. Okay. So with this, today we have completed our four topics, that is operators, types of error, keywords and identifiers, and data types and type casting. Clear? So now, the class is going to end and there should be a homework for you all, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So what's your task? What task you all want? Tell me. You want me? Are you going to share the PPT in Slack? Yeah, sure. I will share all the PPTs there. So what what you want. You want to do the questions on your own, or should I send some questions to you for writing the programs? Tell me which way you all are comfortable with.
You can share the questions.
Yes.
Then
yes,
we will be writing an answer.
Okay. So today I will share some output questions and some writing programs with you all in the Slack group, and tomorrow we will discuss them. And one more thing, remember that I have said in starting, create your GitHub accounts and upload all these things in your GitHub account. Clear?
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. And I would be wanting all the notebook links which you have practiced today in my Slack group. The Slack group which is created, you all are there. I would be wanting all the notebooks there. And the ones who are having the doubts, there were some questions in which it was like int is not callable and these things, right? One was of Supriya, I think. Right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am, ho gaya.
It is fine. Now no issue?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. So, Manas Bhanushali, which account? The Slack group in which we all are there. Rishi, GitHub. Okay, for GitHub. So, Manas, share that link in that general group only, where everyone is there, you all get the link for this meeting, right? There only you should share the link for your notebooks. Okay, so I hope today you all understood all the concepts which I discussed. If any problem, you can connect with me on Slack, and if there is any issue, we can connect anywhere else, and even I can exchange some AnyDesk IDs with you, and I can share the things and solve all your errors, whatever are there. No, sir, it's already there. So guys, any doubts regarding today's session or not?
No doubts, ma'am.
Yeah, so after this class, immediately I will share this file.
No doubts, ma'am.
No doubts.
Okay.
Yeah, and you can go through it. And if you have any query or doubt, you can just refer back.
Yeah, sure. Just remember one thing, that because you can always. Yes, sir. Continue. Please continue.
Yes. Okay. I was just saying that because today I think the session was very tough in the sense of like the timing. We had more than 2.5 hours continuous class. So maybe for some student it will be too much data to digest in a single day. So I'll just share a file to you so you can just refer back and practice a bit in the evening. Okay. And again, we will cover tomorrow something so that you will have sufficient data to in the weekdays. Fine.
Yeah, that's totally fine.
I'll take this link and share in the group.
Okay, that's very great, Supriya. Very great. Very good.
I have renamed it as the lecture 2. Okay, and then shared with you all in the Slack as well. Here in the general. Fine. Then you can check it there. And also in the WhatsApp group, I will share it. And now I think I should stop recording.